Now let us talk about Rn. So if you take a vector in Rn, x, let me call it as x bar, and this is how it is defined like this: x1, x2, x3, and so on, xn. We denote it as a column matrix. And you know what is x bar transpose? Let me simply write it as x, okay? X transpose, that is x1, x2, and xn. Now you can easily define an inner product on Rn. That's inner product of x comma y. You can take it like this: y transpose multiplied with x. Okay, so that's what y1, y2, and so on, yn, multiplied with this x1, x2, and so on, xn. So this is the usual dot product only: y1 into x1 plus y2 into x2 plus and so on plus yn into xn. Okay, so now if you take two vectors x and y, let's say x comma y are two vectors in Rn, and when do you say these two are orthogonal? X and y are said to be orthogonal when their inner product is zero. Inner product of x comma y is zero. Okay. So let me take two orthogonal elements. Let me say 1 comma 0. This is orthogonal to 0 comma 1. You can see that their dot product is 0. Okay. Now I'd like to extend this definition to matrices. When do you say a matrix is orthogonal? So let me do one thing. Let me create a matrix here. One, one, zero, zero. No, one, zero, zero, two. Let me take this. Now this is a matrix A, and I'd like to find a matrix B such that this matrix B is perpendicular to A. So first you should ask me one thing: what is the inner product you are taking on matrices? So you can take this inner product, trace of B transpose A. So this inner product you can take. So you do one thing, you take this inner product and tell me, you take it as a homework. So this is the inner product you need to consider: inner product of AB equal to trace of B transpose A. So with this inner product, you tell me what is that matrix B, which is perpendicular to A. Okay. And the next thing is, you take a matrix which contains columns in such a way that one is orthogonal to another. Let's say let me take this, and then minus 1 and 1. You look at the first column and second column, the columns are orthogonal here. Okay. Do you observe that? The columns are orthogonal. The first column is orthogonal to the second column. Now let me take A transpose. What is transpose of it? That is 1 minus 1, 1 and 1. And let me do one thing. Let me multiply A and A transpose. So if I multiply them, what is it I get? 1 times this minus 1 times this. So 1 times the first column minus 1 times this. So this is 2, 0. Whereas, what is the second column? Just add addition of these two columns, you'll get 0 and 2. So if the columns are orthogonal, you got this matrix, right? Let me do one thing. Let me check it for a 3 by 3 matrix. If I take A equal to 1, 2, 1, I'd like to pick up a 1 which is orthogonal to this, 0, 1, minus 2. So these two are orthogonal. And the next one, let me take minus 1, 0, 1. And what about these two? Are these two orthogonal? No, these two are not orthogonal. One, 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 0, minus 1, 1, minus 1, 0, 1. Now these two are not getting orthogonal. No. Are you getting it? What I am trying to do? I take a vector here, 1, 0, 0. A column, and then another column I'd like to write it this way, and you give me another column which is orthogonal to these two, which is it is perpendicular to these two. It is easy if I take it like this, 1 0 0 0 2 0 0 0 3. But the thing is, if I start with some random vector 1 2 3, so what is the other? Maybe the next one is easy to construct. You can take 2 here and minus 1 here and 0. And how about the next one? I'm looking for a vector which is perpendicular to these two. I wish this to be perpendicular to these two. Okay, let me take 1, minus 1 and minus 1. So, are they all orthogonal? Let me take V1, V2, V3. V1 times V2, like V1 transpose into V2. What is it? So, when you take V1 dot V2, you're going to get 2 minus 2 plus 0. You're getting 0. Next, V1 dot V3, I'm getting minus 2. Minus 1, minus 2, plus 3. Yes, I'm getting 0. Next, V2 dot V3. Minus 2, oh no. Plus 1. It's not getting 0. So these two are not orthogonal. Then what is it you suggest here? You can take ABC. So if I take ABC, what I expect is A plus 2B plus 3C. I expect this to be 0. Next one is 2a minus b plus 0, c equal to 0. Now from the second equation I get b equal to minus 2a, and from the first equation, once if b is minus 2a, a minus 4a, a minus 4a equal to minus 3c, so therefore minus 3a equal to minus 3c, therefore a equal to c. Now you should take a equal to c and b equal to minus 2a, then it will work. Let me see. 1, 2, 3, 2, minus 1, 0. Once if a is 1, c must be 1, b must be minus 2. Yeah, this will work. Now this is what a. And remember, this is the matrix where the columns are orthogonal. Where the columns are orthogonal. Okay. Now I'd like to see what happens to A transpose into A, or A into A transpose, whatever. So let me write A transpose. That is 1, 2, 1, 2, minus 1, minus 2, 3, 0, 1. And let me multiply with A, 1, 2, 1. So when I take the product, what is it I get? See, the first element here, the length of the first column, if you observe, 1 square plus length square, 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square. So you are going to get 9 plus 4 plus 1, 15 you get. And the next thing, this one is perpendicular to this, right? Because we know the first row is perpendicular. Yes, we know that the first column is perpendicular to the second column. So this will be 0, whereas next, this column, this row, perpendicular to this column here. So you'll get 0. Are you getting 0? No, right? I wrote it wrong. This one is
minus. Sir, b equals to 2a, sir.
Amma? Now we are getting 0, I think. 1 minus 4 plus 3. Yeah, we are getting. And next, you can see this is 0. And what is the length of the other guy? 4 plus 1 plus 0. That will be 5. 0, 0, 0, and what is it? 1 plus 4 plus 1.
Minus 2, sir. Minus
2. Huh? Minus 2 ga adhuga, minus ra adhuga, like positive was there.
Okay.
Okay, so now we can observe one thing. If you take a matrix where the columns are orthogonal, then A transpose into A will give you a diagonal matrix. Okay, so in the next class we'll discuss these matrices. A matrix where A into A transpose equal to 1. Sorry, not 1, identity matrix. But here, if you observe that, getting A into A transpose as an diagonal matrix, but there I'm looking for an identity matrix. Now you can think how the columns will be. See, what we are getting here is, if you look at 15, what is 15? 15 is nothing but 1 square plus 2 square plus 3 square. That is length of the square of length of the first column. Okay, so if you want 1 there, you do one thing, you take a vector in such a way that its length is 1. 1 minute, just a minute. Yeah. Now, if you want to construct such a matrix, so you look for a column here where its length is 1. Next, and you look for another column here, its length is 1, and the important thing is this is perpendicular to the first one. Like the first column is perpendicular to the second column. Next, you look for a column here whose length is 1 and it is perpendicular to the first column and as well as second column. Now you can find such a matrix. A into A transpose equal to identity. Okay, and we are going to give a name for it, an orthogonal matrix. So we'll discuss more about it in the next class. See here, right? If I take A transpose into A, I got a diagonal matrix. What about A into A transpose? Am I going to get a diagonal matrix? 1, 2, 1, 2, minus 1, minus 2, and 3, 0, 1. Now this will become A transpose. That is 1, 2, 1. And this guy is 2 minus 1, 0, 1, what I am writing, 1, 2, 1. Now here if you observe that A into A transpose is not a diagonal matrix, because
A matrix A, V2 and V3 are not orthogonal.
Ardham kaledamma.
Matrix A lo V2 and V3 orthogonal ga ledhu sir.
Matrix A lo V2 and V3.
Last two columns sir.
Ee rendu orthogonal ga levu unnai ga. Oh, minus. Oh. Aam kada.
B equals to 2A vastundi sir. Na B equals to minus 2A ani teeskoncha.
Yes, this is plus, so this will be plus. After 1 and 2 orthogonal kondaga
after APCK relation mark
yeah correct. Let me do one thing. If I take plus, it won't work. Fine, everything will change. But anyway, let me talk in terms of columns itself, like C1, C2, C3. I constructed a matrix where C1 is perpendicular to C2 and C2 is perpendicular to C3 and C1 is perpendicular to C3. Now you do one thing. You take it as a homework. You write some observations. Let us say A is a matrix, A is a square matrix, okay? And here you came to know that the columns are perpendicular. Then what can you say about A transpose into A? And similarly, can you conclude anything about A into A transpose if the columns are orthogonal? Next, you start with a matrix, square matrix, where the rows are orthogonal. Orthogonal, I mean perpendicular. One row is perpendicular to the other row. That's what I mean. If you take any two rows of them, they will be perpendicular. Now, what can you say about A transpose into A and A into A transpose? Next. And the next thing is you start with a matrix A where the rows are perpendicular and the columns are perpendicular. Then in that case, what can you say about A and A into A transpose and A transpose into A? Okay, so do this exercise. Let me check here if the b equal to 2a, let me solve it and write the matrix clearly. When b equal to 2a, then I get 5a equal to 3c. So a equal to 3c by 5. Am I correct? So, and I came to know b equal to 2a. Let me do one thing. C equal to 5a by 3. See, if I take a equal to 3, a equal to 3, b equal to 6.
A equal to minus 3, minus 6.
Mainly minus, minus is less than, okay, minus. So C equal to minus 5. Am I correct now?
Okay.
Then the matrix will be 3, 6, minus 5. Yes. Now the columns are orthogonal, right? 1, 2, 3. That is 3 plus 12, 15, minus 15, correct? And 2 minus 2, correct? Okay, so the columns are orthogonal. But how about rows? Are the rows orthogonal here? 2 minus 2, no. You're getting 18. The dot product of first row, two rows, you're getting 18. So they are not orthogonal. So this is what your homework. The homework is to construct a square matrix where the columns are perpendicular and investigate about A transpose into A and A into A transpose. Next thing, construct a matrix where the rows are orthogonal. Em ledandi transpose teeskunte rows orthogonal avutayi ga. Once if you construct A where the columns are orthogonal, meer B equal to A transpose teeskunde ayipoyindi. So the rows will be orthogonal there. Next, this is a tough job, constructing a matrix where the rows and columns are perpendicular. You have to be very, very careful. Okay, so here I'll stop it. And let me know if you have any questions or doubts.